Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is November 18th, 2013, at 9:13 p.m. Eastern Time. Okay, the people, the following video I'm about to make, right, is dedicated to all my friends on Facebook, especially, but I'm gonna post it on YouTube also, but it's dedicated to all my friends on Facebook. It's a very interesting video. Why is it my friends on Facebook? Because you all have inspired me. Wow, you all have inspired me. I'm about to show you all a great revelation. Okay, my friends on Facebook, I'm about to show you all. Sorry, I don't have my camera stand. So my hands are wobbly and I'm trying to speak at the same time. Anyway, I'm about to show you all a spectacular revelation, my friends on Facebook. Okay? And wow, y'all inspired it. Okay? Y'all have inspired this great truth. So, since I don't have my camera stand, let me go inside and continue the video, okay? I'm kind of excited, that's why probably why my hand is shaking. I'm excited at the discovery that my friends have inspired. Okay? Maybe I'm so excited, I can't wait to show you guys what you guys have inspired. Ignorance is bliss. Knowledge is power. Hey Osiris. Hey ya. Okay, my friends. After I called the moon Osiris, right? I stood here thinking. Now, what am I going to say to my friends? How am I going to put into words what they have helped inspired in me? And people, no BS. It's like a rush of wisdom, knowledge, overstanding. It's like all of your questions and all of your comments. It's like they came flooding to my head like a river and just burst like a dam. And wow, people, I cannot express it into words, but your comments and your statements have helped to uncover something, right? That some of the questions that we have all been asking and some of the suspicions, some of the lies that we all know exist. People, I'm about to expose them. Okay, I'm about to bring to you guys the meaning of the word virgin and what virgin birth really means, because virgin birth doesn't mean from a woman who never had sexual intercourse. Y'all have been tricked into believing that, and I'm going to prove it to you guys. Okay, so Jesus Christ wasn't born of the virgin birth, neither was Harold. I'm going to show you all how what the word virgin mean and how y'all being tricked. Okay, I'm gonna prove to y'all that the moon, there's a connection between the moon and Poseidon. Okay, I'm not gonna pronounce the words how you all say it, but you all should know what I mean. Okay, and I'm gonna show y'all the connection between the moon, Poseidon, and Osiris. Because Poseidon is the god of the sea. The moon controls the sea. The moon also represents Osiris. I'm going to prove to you all what Heru means. Heru means man and womankind. We are the Herus. I'm going to prove it to you guys. And I'll prove to you guys that the sun is our right eye. And the moon is our left eye, which means by day, Before they had all this electricity or whatever, even that, even if they had it, it doesn't matter. But by day, we see by the light of the sun. And by night back then, when the moon was closer to Earth and much brighter, we see by the light of the moon. So the sun was our right eye and the moon our left. I'm going to prove to you guys that the moon and the left eye signifies intellect, wisdom, and word power. Because the moon is the one that gives you your intellect and your wisdom and your word power. It comes from the moon. While your life and everything else come from the sun. I'm going to prove to you guys that the signs and the US $1 bill, yeah, they mean what you all suspect that they mean, but it goes even further. Okay? It goes even further than that you all have even think about. And so, remember people, I haven't had much time to prepare this, right? I mean, like I said, by reading your comments tonight and going out there to the moon with the camera, wow, what a flood of information that just came to my head. So this is going to be a rough and tumble, but so I ask you all to bear with me. And guys, I hope you all don't mind, but I'm going to show some of your comments. And I'm going to show some stuff and your name is going to show up. I apologize for that in advance, but you should not be, I know some of you are very private and you don't want your name and stuff out on YouTube and stuff. But remember guys, remember this. You consider this like a class, okay? Like a university. You're the universe and you're in a class. And you have made comments and statements that have impressed the teacher, the professor, the messenger. You have asked questions and you have posed comments that have impressed me. And it impressed our creator. It impressed the cosmos. So much that they have given me some great revelations to share with you guys. So don't be mad or afraid that I might show your name or your comment. Be proud of yourself that your interaction, your energy have helped to bring about what I'm about to show you guys. Be proud that you participate in something so simple, that what you have participated in has overthrown Christianity, Islam, and all the other arms of religion out there. The lies they're telling you guys about God and stuff like that. What you all have participated in have overthrown those. And those of you who have eyes to see and ears to hear, you will believe me what I'm about to show you. And it will change your mind. If you haven't, mind have changed already, it will change it forever. Because these are not just powerful words. These are your words and these are signs. Okay? So these people I named, they asked for this. So if you're in a class and you made a request to your professor and you inspire your professor to bring you a great message, the professor have a moral responsibility to point you all out for being the ones who truly, truly inspire, or who truly lit the spark that's gonna blaze this fire. It only takes a spark to get a fire going, and sooner those around will warm up in its glowing. That's how it is with Ra's love. Once you experience it, you will spread it out to everyone who wants to pass it on. So, I'm about to pass on this knowledge to you guys, and thank you guys for requesting it. Okay, so now people, let me prove to you guys, right, that this saying, the cosmos is like a book. Anyone who learns the language can read the knowledge and history of humanity. Neta is in the self or nowhere else. If it is found in self, it will be found everywhere. Now, nether means God. And he's saying here, God is found in the self. If God ain't found in you, then it's nowhere else. If it's found in you, then it's found in everybody else. It's found everywhere. The cosmos is like a book. And you all are the cosmos, the stars, the gods. Because the Egyptian belief, the gods were the universe, the stars, the sun, the moon, the planets. Those are the gods. They each represent a personality. And they are found in you. Okay, so you are the cosmos. And your comments is like a book. And anyone who learns a language can read the knowledge and history of humanity. Okay, let's go to this one. These are words, right, that came from the Kemetic chart. Speak truth, do truth. Morals are judged by deeds. The visible world is ephemeral. The spirit world is forever. Searching for oneself in the world is a pursuit of illusion. Evils and good both operate to advance a great plan. Okay? But what I really want to show you guys is right here. Complexity is a decadent of society. Simplicity is a path to reality and salvation. Now, people, this is very important, okay? Complexity. Dying and going to heaven in Jesus' name. Jesus was crucified on the cross for man's sin. But yet God says, thou shalt not kill. But then God somehow gave these men permission to kill his one only begotten son. Think about that, people. Isn't it confusing? Then, this man was born from a virgin birth. This lady never had sex. And she gave birth to this man. Isn't that kind of confusing? It's complexity. Can you fathom that? Then, they tell you that in order for you to get salvation, you have to believe that Jesus Christ died and rose from the dead. And you have to believe that. So if you're not a Christian, if you are a Buddhist or Muslim, or you came from China or some other place, or you were born in the woods, and you didn't grow up in this Jesus Christ mess, there's no salvation for you. But you're a good person. You're not evil. You give birth to those who have no fear. You have created thyself a good name in posterity. So how is it that you're going to hell? It's complexity. But it's the decadence of society. Someone teach you how simplicity is a path to reality and salvation. So, now, let's go to another quote. Okay, these are very important, people, okay? Because it goes to the point I'm about to show you guys. Deities were divine personification of certain letters. Principle, power, or attribute of the one divine deity. That, remember that, people. Remember that word. One divine deity, okay? Each deity was an aspect of the human psyche that they could harness and realize in its supreme form. So, what I tell you, people, that you can be like the supreme, the one deity, the one divine deity. You could be like him. If you could harness each of the other deities. If you could harness them together. And each of them is in you. Because each deity was an aspect of the human psyche. So, the Almighty, okay, the divine deity is in each one of you. Okay? So, what that tells you, you all should know where I'm going with this. That Jesus Christ... Okay. Jesus Christ tell you all that he is the one and only Son, one and only begotten Son of God, the one and only begotten Son of God. And You gotta die. You gotta believe that he was murdered for you. In order for you to go into heaven where the Almighty resides. But yet the Egyptian who came thousands of years before Jesus Christ tell you a different thing. You are your own Jesus Christ. You is the one who was, you are the begotten Son of God. Son and daughters of God. You, the one and only is you. Each one of you, individually, is the one and only. Because the Supreme is in you. You are the Almighty. Each one of you is the Almighty. Each one of you is the Almighty. It's telling you here. In Christianity, an example would be the trade of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. Because, hey, each deity manifested itself in a particular way. Okay? Thus, complementing the essence of the other deities. So, it's telling you right here. Okay? Okay? How simple can it get? Because if you are suspect that, then I'm going to heaven in Jesus' name, that all sound like nonsense to you. If you believe that, wait a minute, I'm a good person. I have fed the poor. I've healed the sick. What evil have I done for this evil God to want to put me into hell? Because I don't accept his gift of brutality, of bloodshed and murder, when he say, thou shalt not kill. Yet he want me to accept the murder of his son. It doesn't make no sense. And people, imagine you're murdering the Son of God and you put him on a cross and you make images of it and you put it in a church and you kneel on it and pray and you hold up cross around your neck and you go to God and you hold it up and say, God bless me please, give me long life, give me riches, heal me, give me a beautiful woman, give me a nice man, give me a car. You ask God for those with a cross in your hand or on your neck or kneel down before it. You're calling God to come. Come God, look at me holding up my trophy. Look at me holding up this thing. Look at me kneeling down before this thing with your son impaled on it, with his dead eyes chained up at heaven, with a permanent screw on his face, a permanent disappointment on his face. My Lord, why have you forsaken me? Imagine that, people. Imagine any one of you. Because remember, you are like God. Each one of you is the divine, almighty. So Jesus Christ is your son. Because each one of you are the divine. And your children. Your children is Jesus Christ. Imagine I kill your child. I nail him on a cross. And say, you pay for my sins. I kill a man. Now you pay for it. Because it's like snitching. Somebody do a crime and they don't want to pay for it. So it's a cop out. They go and snitch somebody else out to get it after the crime. So I commit a crime. I don't want to pay for it. You pay for it. It's like when two guys in a car and one kill somebody else, and the two of them get caught, and the murderer don't want to take the heat. So he's going to go down and he's going to take his friend down with him. When he know he commit the crime, he's crucifying his friend. He saying, you're going to pay for my crime. It's the same thing. So imagine me, murder your child, and nail him on a cross, and come before you and say, Rhonda, Marie, Donna, bless me please. Bless me. Give me long life. And you look, you come down and you see me with an image of your child impaled on a cross. Wouldn't you be repulsed? Wouldn't you turn your face away in anger and shock? Wouldn't you tear off my head and rip me apart and stamp me in the ground until you can't stamp me no more? That would be your first reaction. You are God Almighty. You are the divine deity. The one divine deity is you. Because each one of us is him. So imagine if you, the one divine deity, an aspect, an aspect of the one divine deity would be repulsed at the image of your child nailed on a cross with a permanent screw of disappointment on his face, with his dead eye looking up at you. Why did you forsake me? If you, who could love so much, that you would not accept this and bless anyone, how much more with the one true almighty creator would not accept such idiocy, such brutality, such complexity? Because if he created all things, like you all say, with his hands, and he said, let there be. No, if he created with his mouth, he said, let there be. But we don't know how he was created. He just appeared to Noah and said, let there be. Let there be light. He created it. I seen some posts on YouTube, on Facebook. If God created the sun on the fourth day, how did 3 days pass? And I thank my friend for posting that. I can't remember who it was, but I seen it. And it makes sense. Because didn't God say the sun and the moon divided the days? So if the sun, it's in the Bible, the sun and the moon divide the days. So if the sun and the moon divide the days, and God created the sun in a fourth day, how the hell did the 3 days pass? It's complexity. Think about it, people. It's idiocy. Foolishness. When I was a child, I speak as a child, I believe as a child, but now I have become a man, I put away all childish things. That's idiocy, it's complexity, it's confusing. Cast that aside, my Christian brothers and sisters, cast that BS aside. So, the point I'm trying to make now is that we are all God, and we will not accept any idiocy what I'm trying to make say is, if God can say, God took dirt and create man, and he said, let there be light. He created the animals. He created everything by the word of his mouth. So if God is so powerful that he could do that, why the hell do he have to send his only son to be butchered, to give man the satisfaction of butchering his son, so that we could be saved? Why can't he just reach out his hand and save us? Why can't he just reach out his hand and save us? If he's so powerful and almighty, can a woman forget her nursing child? Are the fruits of her womb? Because we know God can't be no man, because man, well, I shouldn't say that. Let me get off that subject. So the point being, people, we know that none of you will accept such idiocy of your child being impaled on a cross for someone else's brutality. Just like you wouldn't accept it, so the Almighty God wouldn't accept it either. Because think about it, people. Imagine George W. Bush. Imagine Hitler. And all those evil mass murderers who commit genocide, the Rothschild and them, going back hundreds of years. Imagine how much mass murders these people have committed. Okay? All they have to do before they die is say, I believe that Jesus Christ died and he rose from the dead for my sin. Forgive me, Lord. That's all they have to say. That's all they have to say. And they will be in heaven with their victims. My Jewish brothers and sisters, think about it. Would you all wish to be in heaven at the same table with Adolf Hitler, who you all say killed over 6 million of your people by gas and all kind of atrocities? No, think seriously. My Jewish brothers and sisters, would you all want to sit in heaven with Adolf Hitler, shaking hands, loving and kissing him. Thank you, my brother. Hail, my brother. Which one of you want to do that? Wouldn't you rather sit in hell and fight the devil? No, wouldn't you rather be in hell fighting Adolf Hitler? No. My Jewish brothers and sisters, which one of you would not rather be in hell right now fighting Adolf Hitler? Or would you rather be up in heaven at the table of brotherly love, drinking milk and honey, with street paved with gold and virgins? Your choice, heaven with Hitler or hell fighting him. So you see my point? How about you see live big today, tomorrow buried in a casket, because a lot of you want to go to heaven and live good. You are like peace. Okay, you are going to live in heaven with your so-called tormentor when you all have a chance to go to hell and fight him. But yet, many, many millions died to so-called free you guys, but yet you all still want to teach people this nonsense about son of the Jews dying for people's sin. Come on, come on. When are you all going to stop and tell people it's nonsense? I mean, if the Jews was to stand up, even though they deny Jesus Christ, if they was to stand up and tell the Catholic Church, enough. Tell the Christian Church, enough. It's enough. It was fabricated. Tell the truth. Free the people. Don't you see, it's only you all could free the people. Either you all are going to be destruction going to do it. By my mouth and the meditation of my heart. Because their divine almighty is in me. So do it. Free the people. Free the people's soul. Tell them it's BS. They want to hear, they want to take it from me. Only a few will take it from me. But billions will take it from you. Free the planet. Free our souls. Not ours. Well, me, because I'm trapped here with you guys. Because I don't want to go out. Until you all are free, I don't want to be free. Until my people are free, I don't want to be free. And all the other people, you all are my people. So the point is, my Jewish brothers and sisters, call on your leader, free the people. Tell them you all have tricked them. Tell them that you all were a very peaceful people and you all really had no home because you all had to fight. People back then had to fight for tribes, fight for land. And you all had none because you all weren't warmongers. You all were the peaceful people. Abraham left the warmonger tribe of his Babylonian ancestors and he was a peaceful man. But because he was not a warrior, he couldn't go fight for the land. So he used trickery. He used trickery to get an inheritance. I understand that. You weren't a war, you had to get a land. I mean, how was he going to survive? Your people needed a place to call their own. People used sword. There's no difference with what you did and what they did. They used sword and they used brutality and they murdered people for their land. You lied. So when you put a murderer and a liar together, there's really no difference. So all will be pardoned. Okay? There's nothing as easy as to avenge an offense, yet nothing more honorable than to pardon it. You have committed an offense, just like the murderers who kill for land have committed offense, and now you are still using the world and using the same lies to keep your statue in the world, but there's no more need for it. Okay, people, just to interject real quickly, right? I made this video on Friday night, right? I began making it, right? And I promise you guys, I'm going to upload it by Saturday or Sunday. However, for some reason, I had something to do yesterday and I couldn't finish it. And I was angry at myself because I made a promise and I didn't keep it. So now today when I came home, I went on the internet to my Yahoo mail and I discovered the reason why I was not able to upload the video, because my friend Quiet Storm shared a video with me. This video right here. And people, the truth is, what I just said about the Jewish people, honestly, if I had finished this video yesterday, I would have cut it all out. I would have cut out the entire part I said about the Jewish people and move on to what I really want to show you guys about the proof I said I'm going to show you guys. So, I don't want to offend anyone. And I have a friend, Jewish friend, his name is Rob Lieblin. Nobody pronounced his name right. I don't have it before me. But Rob, you know who you are. And Rob have never showed me any racism. He have never showed me any reason to doubt his friendship with me. He have Bob Marley flag in his room, you know, the red, green, and gold. You know, he love reggae music. To me, he's real. He have not shown me any bad face. And I'm not going to apologize to Rob or anyone else for showing the video I'm about to show while I'm speaking. I'm going to overlay. I'm going to overlay the video which Quiet Storm shared with me. And while I continue the video, I'm not going to apologize to anyone because, Rob, you know where me and you stand. I show you no hatred, you show me none. As far as I'm concerned, you're my brother. So I hope you take no offense, but this is disgusting. It's disgusting what's going on in your native land. It's disgusting, my brother. So anyway, here, let me continue with the video. I was going to cut it out, but now I'm going to continue. So it was divine. So Quiet Storm, enough respect. Thank you. So let's continue from where I just cut out. Okay, here we go. You won a war, you had to get a land. I mean, how are you going to survive? Your people needed a place to call their own. People use sword. There's no difference with what you did and what they did. They used sword and they used brutality and they murdered people for their land. You lied. So when you put a murderer and a liar together, there's really no difference. So all will be pardoned. Okay? There's nothing as easy as to avenge an offense, yet nothing more honorable than to pardon it. You have committed an offense, just like the murderers who kill for land have committed offense. And now you are still using the world and using the same lies to keep your statue in the world. But there's no more need for it. You all are people just like everybody else. Now you all have nuclear weapons. You all have military. You all have one of the finest military in the world. There's no need for the lies to continue. But if you tell the truth, I guarantee that no one will threaten you. I can guarantee you, my Jewish brothers, if you tell the truth, I guarantee you, no one will threaten you. You are safe. People know you're lying, that's why they threaten you. And you're using your lies to instill your will on other people. You're using your lies to get American Christians to protect you. You're using your lies to take the West Bank. Come on, you are the Palestine, you all are one. So you all need to start living together, side by side. That place in Jerusalem, that dome, is idiocy. There's no power there. It's a place of contention. It's a place of slavery. Let it go. You are fighting over nonsense. The only true temple is in Giza. That's it. Everything else is BS. I was taken from there. They are the copies. Tear them down. And let's go to the real stuff. So the point being, if you were to tell the people the truth and open your borders, no one will ever turn. You'll be safe. Come on. Speak truth. Do truth. Where is it? My Jewish brothers and sisters. Speak truth. Do truth. Morals are judged by deeds. The visible world is ephemeral. The spiritual world is forever. Searching for oneself in this world is a pursuit of illusion. You are making yourself out to be chosen of God. It's a pursuit of illusion because every one of us is a chosen of God. You tricked the people into waiting for Jesus Christ to come. You have tricked them. and it's a pursuit of illusion. Evils and good both operate to advance a great plan, which means the people who murdered to get lands and the people who lied to get lands, it was to advance a great plan. And the plan was that you have a home. So you lied to get a home. Those are the people they butchered to get a home. But which one is the best of the both evils? None. You are about evil. And you are needed to who? Especially the African, because all those lands are was the African land. Kemet. Our lands. Our lands. I don't know where y'all came from. But those are our lands. And you have lied to get our lands. And you have murdered. Commit genocide to get our lands. Evil and good. Because some of you was good. Like the slave traders. They came over like those who came. I mean, sorry, like the pilgrims in America. They came over and pretended that they was good. But it was to advance a great plan to take the Indians' land. So you see, the Romans, the Greeks, that's all they did. Murdered, rape, and pillage to get other people's land. So evil and good operate to advance a great plan. To create civilization, because some of the people were barbaric. There was cannibals, barbaric people. So yes, and I'm not going to lie, Christianity have done a lot of good. Christianity have taken many people out of barbaric ways. Christianity have helped keep this world glued together. Christianity and Islam, yes, you have done good. People, let's give them their credit. Let's give Christianity and Islam their credit. And Buddhism, let's give them their credit. And all the other great religions out there, give them their credit. They have done great. They have kept society civilized. They have kept men from wars. They have healed the sick, fed the poor. Give it to them. But there was evil in it. Because they lied. They lied, they tricked men. They took men's eyes off and put them into the sky to an invisible God. When God is inside of you. The sun is a physical aspect. The sun and the moon, those are physical aspects. But you cannot see thoughts. You can only feel and read them within you. So they're in you. You are listening to the physical aspect. So, the point being, these religions have done great evils and good, both operate to advance a great plan. So, you all created civilization. You took a lot of people out of, some dire situations. But you all have done evil. And there's nothing as easy as to avenge an offense, which is the Almighty Creator. There's nothing as easy as to avenge an offense, yet nothing is more honorable as to pardon it. So what he's saying to you guys, tell the truth. And he will pardon you. But sometimes you keep lying, you are going to get what's coming to you all. Complexity is a decadence of society. Simplicity is a path to reality and salvation. So now I'm going to show you all simplicity. I'm going to show you all the true meaning of this BS that the people have been teaching you guys. Okay? So let me go back to this one and show you all. Okay. Okay, in Kemet, which is Africa, Egypt, religion was seen as an active catalyst interacting in one's daily life, not just on Sundays, Saturdays, and Fridays, or as sometimes outside of oneself. The spiritual kingdom was within oneself. So you ask where heaven is at, people? Do you ask where heaven is at? Their spiritual kingdom was within oneself. Okay? And one's deeds would be judged at death. Many ideas, rituals, hymns, amulets and scriptures of the Kemet are closely parallel, are copied in many of today's religion. World religion, including Hinduism, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, have their origin in Kemetic philosophy. As in most religion, the Kemetic initiate gained a deeper understanding of knowledge by learning the obvious and hidden meaning of their philosophical system. As fire purifies matter, all souls must go through their own form of spiritual purification. So people, I'm about to take you all to the fire, and you must come out, right? You must go to your own spiritual purification and free your mind from all those idiot beliefs you all had before about God and Jesus Christ, and then going to heaven in Jesus' name, and about the signs and the US dollar bill. Okay? This system was based on the law that all creation was part of an expression of the divine force. So you see, people, all creation was part of an expression of the divine force, which means the Almighty Creator, each one of you is an expression of Him. So He's telling you there's none more special, there's none more chosen than any one of you. It's how you act, it's your deeds. If you do truth and speak truth, that's what makes you the Almighty. Okay. Everyone was accountable for his or her own actions and salvation. So you see, people, everyone was accountable for his or her own actions and salvation. Now, people, remember Hero or Horus, right? Remember Jesus Christ was plagiarized from Horus. So at the time Horus existed and was crucified, they still believe that everyone was accountable for his or her own actions and salvation. So Hell didn't come to save anybody. Hell come to show you guys how to save yourself. And Hell is mankind. Each one of you, people, I'm going to prove to you all, each one of you is Hell. Each one of you is Hell. So which means that each one of you, every man, is responsible for his own action and salvation. Does that mean you cannot do no BS and go say you're going to put it on Jesus Christ? Because you're responsible for your own actions and accountable for them. So that means, like one of my friends said, simplicity, no hell, and no savior. Okay? So, now, today understanding the Kemetic philosophical system might be easier if one sees the deities not as gods, okay, but as states of consciousness. So you see, people, so these things are not gods. They're not things for you to worship. They are state of consciousness. So Heru is you guys. Okay? Osiris is you guys. Because you are the Osiris. Each one of you are the Osiris. We are the dead. We have been incarnated here on earth to live out our desires. Words said by Osiris. So we are the dead. We are the Osiris. So it's improved, people. Everyone was accountable for his or her own actions and salvation. So you came to earth to live out your life desire. So whatever you do in this life, you cannot give it to Jesus Christ, because you came on earth specifically. Specifically, people, you came on earth to live out your desire. The aspect, you are an aspect of the Almighty. Good and evil. So there's no Satan. There's no devil. It's you. You are the Satan. You are the devil. Each one of you are Satan, devil to each other. When you commit evil, you are Satan. You're the devil. When you do good, you're the how you all say God or Jesus Christ, however you want to say. So it's you. They know. It's a thought. So, if one sees the deity not as gods, but as states of consciousness, and the embodiment of certain universal principles. Okay, people? So you all see, it's a consciousness, say a consciousness. So when we say the devil, it's a consciousness in you. You have a choice to ward him off. You have the power to ward him off or to encourage him. Okay? Matter can be neither created nor destroyed. Neither can collective ideas be destroyed. So you see, people, so collective ideas cannot be destroyed. What that tells you, when these people came up with their Christianity, it's been for 2,000, these collective ideas have been so powerful ever since religion was created. They've been so powerful that for thousands of years, these collective ideas of how to enslave man has been, wow. So now it's time for us to destroy it. Let's prove that it could be destroyed. It can only be destroyed if we do truth and speak truth. That's how we destroy these collective ideas of the enslavement of religion. Because each one of us are our own God. We don't need to go into no church and not sing no hallelujah and give our 10% like my friend Rwanda said. Giving, buying your way into heaven. You have to give 10% to get your way into heaven. People, don't you all know? Before I go forward, let me give you a quick story, because it's very important. When I was a kid, I read this story, and it was the truth. I found a book, old book, a very old book, and I read it. And in that book, people, it tell you how Christianity started. It's not how the internet and all these people tell you about how the guy say he see some, he look up and he see Jesus Christ in the sky, and tell him to follow him. You know how Christianity started? The Romans, first, the Romans and everyone else used to build statues. They cut down tree, they burn some in the fire, and they bake bread. And they take another half, and they make themselves a god. And they bow down and they worship it. That's what they did. But then the people start saying, but wait a minute. Sometime when there was wars, other tribes came and knocked down these gods. Knocked them down. At other times, right, if the wind blew too hard, it would knock down these gods. Or something, these gods would fall down and break to pieces. And people say, well, wait a minute. If that is God, how the hell could it fall down? If that is God, how the hell can it pick itself up? If that is God, how the hell did I make it with my hands? So if you say, wait a minute, no, we're being tricked. That cannot be God. A man made it. So now the priest and the leader started getting scared now, because you know people, that's how you control the people, about telling them God say. Dogma, I'm God. That's how they do it. So they trick the people by telling them God say. So to keep order, they lie. Or they use a sword. So now, the real leaders now, they got scared and panicked. Say, wow, if the people start believing God, they're gonna realize that we've been lying to them. They're gonna overthrow us. So they say, okay, let's say the king is God. Let's take it from the statue and say the king is God. So now they start worshiping the kings as gods, as the divine God incarnated on earth. Are the children of the gods. So they start making statues now. And when they make the statue, they say it's a statue to the king. Or to the god that's inside the king. So now the king says, okay, I'm God. So now people, when the king got sick, right? He couldn't heal himself. He had to send for his magician. And when the king died, the king would die. He said, but wait a minute. How the hell can God die? How the hell, if he created me, how the hell can he die? How come he can't heal himself, but yet he's telling me to do all this? How the hell can God have to send for magicians? So the magicians are more powerful than God. So the people say, man, that's nonsense. So now the rulers got scared. And the priests got scared. Say, wow, the people are getting smarter. So the people start worshiping the kings of God as gods. So the rulers, they panic. And they say, okay, let's, you know what, something? The Jews have a God that no one have ever seen. The Jews have a God that no one can destroy, because you cannot see what you can, you can't destroy what you can't see. He can't die because you cannot see him. Let us take up the Jewish God as our God and make the people follow him. That's how Christianity started, people. They said, let us take up the Jewish God and make it into our God so that the people will follow us. So they took the Christian thing, this Jesus Christ thing, and took the Egyptian Jesus, Egyptian hero, and they mixed them together, and the Jehovah and the Egyptian, the Kemetic story about creation, they took them and they put them together, right? And created this lie. Okay, now people, let's go to the US $1 bill now, right? I'm about to prove to you guys something. What hero really means. I'm gonna prove to you guys, right? I'm about to debunk Christianity and debunk all you people who say that this, the eye and the US dollar bill, that is an evil eye, is an eye of Satan. I'm gonna prove to you guys that you are speaking idiocy. You're Jesus Christ, that's the devil. It's a state of consciousness. He cannot save you guys, it's a state of consciousness. It's in your heads. So which means he cannot save you guys, he cannot forgive you for your sins. He didn't die for you. So all of you who said that this eye here is the eye of the devil, you are foolish, guys, your eye. This is your eye, your intellect. That's what it means. Your intellect. The left eye of Herod lost in this fight with Set. You know what Set means? Okay. Hold on. I'm going a little bit too fast, right? Actually, I'm not. Those of you who criticize this symbol here and call it this mark of the devil and say it's evil, you are like, I won't call you all that. You all are misled. Okay? Ignorance is bliss. Knowledge is power. I'm going to show you all right now some knowledge that will take away the ignorance from you. That this is salvation. This is power of the Almighty Creator. It's you. So, this right here is the eye of Herod. It means intellect. But your Christians have lost your intellect. It's telling you all, it's showing you all, your Christians have lost your intellect and your wisdom. In your fight with Set, you got your son has Set. You know what Set means? It means, Set means, symbolize destruction, chaos, and confusion. Destruction, confusion, and chaos. Okay? That's what Set means. So you have lost. So what, remember when I tell you about complexity? Is that the decadence of society? And simplicity is the way to salvation. Set symbolizes destruction, confusion, and chaos. So this left eye of Herod is symbolized the intellect. But before I show you all what I'm trying to say, this is it, the wedget. The left eye of Herod lost in his right in his fight with Set. Then it was told by Tehuri. The widget was worn as a pendant to ward off evil and give the rear protection, symbolize healing, protection, and health. But it means more than that, because y'all are only reading a part of it. You gotta read the cosmos, your entire body is a cosmos. You cannot just read about the eye. You gotta read the entire, what else go with the eye? So, remember, it was restored by Tehuri. Tehuri is a netter. He's a god. So you got to go to Tehuri and see what Tehuri symbolized. Because if the left eye was destroyed by Tehuri, right? If the left eye was destroyed by Tehuri, then you got to see what did Tehuri restore. It cannot be just left eye. You have to restore something with it. So what did Tehuri... In order to find out what the left eye means, right? You gotta find out what Tehuri means, because Tehuri was the one who restored it. Okay, Tehuri, the scribe of the Netura gods and the deity which represent wisdom and knowledge, also represented as an ibis or baboon. Tehuri is connected to the moon. Okay? Tehuri is connected to the moon. Remember I told you about the moon? He is connected to the moon. Okay? So now you ask where this is going. The left eye is the moon. The left eye of Heru is the moon. And this is the eye of Heru. So the left eye of Heru is the moon. Who is Heru? Man. So the moon is the left eye. And it was lost in a fight with Set, with chaos, confusion, and destruction. Because confusion leads to chaos, and chaos leads to destruction. So when all they have to do is confuse you, you know, the complexities of society, all they have to do is confuse you, and that confusion is gonna lead to chaos. And the chaos is going to lead to destruction. Your destruction. Because as long as you believe in some other God is going to save you, and there's a hell, that's where you're headed. But then God's going to save you. But you're going to head to hell for real. Because that's what you ask for. It's a state of consciousness, my people. You die believing you're going to heaven. When there's no heaven, except in you, you're going to go to what they call it, purgatory or whatever. That's where you're going to be, you in limbo. That's why the souls cannot ascend, because they're in limbo. So many millions, hundreds of millions, billions of Christians who have died, their soul are in limbo. That's why earth is so like it stated, you know, their soul are in limbo, because they expect to go to some place that doesn't exist. It's an illusion. So the point being, right, the Christians have lost their left eye, the intellect. And that's what the people who designed the dollar bill and the symbol, that's what I want to show you guys. America was supposed to be a secular nation. But they turned it into a... And they were warning you guys. Do not lose your intellect. In God we trust. God, people, God. The netters. The moon, the sun. Not in Jesus Christ or Jehovah, but in the moon and the sun. The one that you could see. Not the invisible, but the ones that you could see, because the invisible is in you. The invisible part is in you. In your mind, in your thoughts, in your heart and soul, that's where they are. But the physical aspect are in the skies, the moon and the sun. So anyway, Heru, you are Heru, right? So now we got, now we see that the left eye is the moon. So this eye here in the pyramid that they have right here on the US dollar bill is the moon, the intellect. And it's the right eye of Heru. The left eye of Heru, which is mankind. It's our left eye, but we have lost it. We have lost our way. And they are tricked by religion. So, now, back to Tehuri. Okay. Tehuri, the scribe of the Netura gods and the deity which represented wisdom and knowledge, also represented as an ibis or baboon. Tehuri is connected to the moon. Wisdom, scribes, and sciences. Okay? At judgment time, he would write down the weighing of the soul. What does Tehuri symbolize? Symbolizes word power, intellect, and wisdom. He's connected to the moon. So that means the moon symbolize intellect, wisdom, and word power. Gods don't speak unless they really want to, but mankind can speak. Man can speak. So word power, wisdom, those are what in us. And those energies come from the moon, our moon, because we live in this galaxy, in this planet Earth. So this came from us. So now, I show you all what the left eye means. So those of you think that it's from the devil, you have lost your intellect. You're disrespecting the moon. You're disrespecting from where come your knowledge, your wisdom and your intellect. You lost your intellect. You lost it. And they warned you. They put on the dollar bill. They warn you, don't lose your intellect. When you have this money in your hand, don't go spend it wildly. Don't go spend it stupidly. Don't get trapped by this money. Do not lose your intellect, your wisdom, and your word power. Because this money is also word power. With this money, you could do almost anything. It's power. So you see, okay, anyway, what I'm trying to say, people, right, is I'm going to show you all the symbols, okay? Now, give me 1 second. I want to find a US dollar bill. Okay, people, y'all notice, right? And yes, $1 bill, right? How is it that they have an eagle here, right? And a pyramid over here with the eye, and it say, in God we trust. How is that, people? Why does this have the Egyptian, the Kemet, the Kemetic, the Kemite? Why did this, the United States dollar bill, why do we have the Kemetic images on here? They're warning you all about something. They're warning you all that Christianity is not what y'all think it is. And they put the symbols to warn you guys what y'all wasn't listening. Instead of listening, y'all came up with y'all own crazy ass ideas. Okay? When the symbols are right here, let me find a bigger one because this one look like I cannot see too much on that one. So bear with me. Let me find a better picture. Okay, now people, let me prove to you all, right, what the other symbols and the writings on the US dollar bill really means, right? This is very interesting. Okay, first, notice this eagle, right, people? Notice the eagle. Notice what you have in its feet. In one foot you have an olive branch, right? In the other you have a shaft of arrows. Now, most of you think that these olive branches mean peace and the arrow means war. In a way, it does. In a way, it does. Okay? So, what people, the point I'm trying to make is, does this eagle look familiar to you guys? Let me remember what eagle is having his feet, right? Okay? And you have a shield up against it, right? You see the shield? And above it is like the sun or the universe with the 13 stars or whatever, right? Okay. The Lord God is a sun and a shield. Didn't David say that? For the Lord God is a sun and a shield. Now people, what shield us? What is our shield? The moon. Why do you all think the moon is so battered with some pothole in it? Because the moon protects us from all those asteroids. The moon is getting plummeted every day by asteroids that if the moon was not there, they'd have caught us. Why do you all think the moon travels on the Earth like it does? The moon travels from west to east, then back from east to west. West to east, back from east to west. But the moon is like a shepherd going around the earth, catching all these asteroids. And what the moon don't catch, the sun, no. What escaped the sun is caught by the moon. So when these asteroids escape from the sun's gravity, and come towards Earth, or when they are actually below the sun's gravity and come to Earth, the moon is our shield that protects us. Okay? So now you all see why the moon is dead. He sacrificed his life for us. That's the Jesus Christ right there. Okay? It's our shield. So anyway, the point I'm trying to make, people. Does this picture look familiar to you guys? Let me show it to you all. Falcon, king of the air, king of the gods. One of the form symbolizing hero and energy of the headship. That's very important, people. Energy of the headship, because remember, God is in you. The Almighty, the headship. Okay, and what does, let me finish it, symbolizes kingship, aggression, and mastery. How do you master people? If you don't have no intellect, if you're not smart, how can you be king? How can you symbolize kingship, aggression, and mastery? You gotta have intellect, wisdom, and word power to do these things. So that's what this eagle in the American drawing means. Now, these people couldn't let people know that they're actually worshiping the Kemet stuff, because remember, they have African slaves in America during the time they were creating this stuff. That African slave that they took from Egypt and Ethiopia and the rest of Africa that they stole. So they couldn't use our symbols. So you see, people, they are that city, they have slaves. Yet they're using our symbols. Because a new order. The order of the Kemites. The rest of the Egyptians that you all, first you are chasing out of Egypt and took over their land. Then you all brought them out here. You all deported them from their own land and deported them into the new world. That's why Egypt and Libya, that's why you all Arabs own them. Because you all deported the Kemites out of Egypt. You have deported them to the Americas. So we are the Egyptians. That's who we are. Egyptians. We are Kemites. We are the true ask where the Kemites, they deported us. Okay, and even it's even in the Bible about this eagle that went over to Lebanon, but it's really Africa, and cut off a piece of the top branch and brought it to the new world and planted it. By the rivers of Babylon, where we sat down, there we wept, when we remember Zion, for the wicked carry us away captivity, require from us a song. What's your name? Kunta Kinte. No, it's Toby. What's your name? Kunta Kinte. No, it's Toby. The point I'm trying to make is that for the wicked carry us away captivity, require from us a song. Now how can we sing the Lord God's song in a strange land? So they were trying to make the slaves telling the secrets. Okay? So remember, they require us to sing a song. To sing the song, the praises of Isis and Horus. But they were trying to learn our secrets. That's what that means. So anyway, the point being that the olive branch and the arrows, right, have different meaning. I'm going to show you what they really mean. Now, in Heru, 2 feet, what does he have? He have the sun and the moon. Okay? Remember, Heru is man. And his intellect, which is his third eye, is the moon, the left eye. And his brains is the sun. Okay? His soul and brain is his son. Because he's able to think and act and create and make things. He's able to invent things. Because he's the Almighty Creator. And the Son is a physical manifestation of the Almighty Creator. We cannot see the Creator, but we see his light. And who brings the light? The Son. The Son is the light of the world. So the Son is a physical aspect of our Creator. And that Son, I know you are going to say, oh, they're bigger Son than our Son and older. Yes, yes. An aspect of each, okay? Each God can manifest itself into another God. So the Creator manifests itself in our sons. All the sons are just aspects of the Almighty. We have a son, it's our Almighty. Okay? So our brain is the sun, and our pineal gland, our divine, to materialize things. Okay, because with our third eye, with the moon, we get the intellect and the wisdom to materialize things and to get the thoughts in our head. And with our brains, we are able to manifest them into reality. So the moon is a thought, the conception, and the sun is a reality, is a physical aspect of it, matter. So we think about it with our left eye, and we create it with our right eye. We create it, we make cars. We think about inventing cars and computers and stuff like that. We think about it with our left eye, and then we use our brains to make it with our hands. So you see, your left eye and your right eye. So when you people want to look at the US $1 bill and say, is it evil? You have lost your intellect, you have lost your knowledge. You have no sense. Okay? And I don't blame you, so don't get me wrong. You have been indoctrinated, but it's time to put that idiocy aside, is what I'm trying to say to you all. Anyway, so what does the olive branch signify? This olive branch symbolizes vegetation. Okay? Harvesting. Fertility. And these arrows symbolize what? Remember, Arthur symbolized conception. What caused conception? Sexual intercourse. So now, look at this arrow, and look at the arrow in front of the Vatican, and look at this arrow, the Tecenio, an elongated monumental stone needle-like structure emulates the male penis and rays of the sun, symbolized permanence, strength, and virility, right? That's why he said there, right? So in this American Eagle, which is supposed to be hero, he have in his hand here the tree of life, which is the olive, the tree of life, and he have in here the male penis, which is really the way that the sun. I'm going to show you all what the meaning of the olive branch and the meaning of the arrows in connection to the meaning of the writings up here. Now, up here it says, E pluribus unum. Right? And I'm gonna show you all the meaning of those words and as they relate to what I'm about to demonstrate to you guys, okay? And the other one here says, and with coptis, right? And here say, novus ordo seclorum. Now, what does this word mean? Y'all are being misled. I'm going to show you what it really means. Okay? Now, people, remember I told you guys, right, that The olive branch, right? In the eagle, in American eagle part is the olive branch and the arrows, right? What do they symbolize? Okay. E pluribus unum. Latin, out of many, one. Right? Alternately translated, one out of many. Is a phrase on the seal of the United States, along with Anuit and with Coptis, Latin for he approves of the undertaking, and Novus Ordo Seclorum, Latin for new order of the ages. Okay? Now, Anuit Coptis, Latin for he approves of the undertaking. Who is he, people? Who is he? Where is this written? Over the dollar bill, right? And whose eye is that? The eye of Herod, right? And behind the eye of Herod is the sun, right? So the sun and the moon right here, together. The sun is giving its light to the moon. Okay, and with Coptis, he approves of the undertaking. Who is he? Heru. Ra. That's what they're talking about. Osiris. Heru and Ra. Because it's the left eye of Heru. It's Osiris and Ra is behind here, giving him his energy. So, Anuit Coptis means he, Heru, the Kemetic god, approved the undertaking of the American setting the new order of the ages. But the order of the ages was not supposed to be the one that is going today. Because that's not what the Egyptians was talking about. I'm going to show you all what they really meant. He was trying to tell you all that do not bring this Christianity crap to America. We want to build a secular nation. A secular nation where anybody have the choice to believe in a God or not. To where you could be that you are God. That you is a supreme creation. That you don't have to go and worship and spend your money and buy tickets to heaven and all that crap. Because Egyptians didn't believe in that. Okay, the Kemites, the conquerors did, the Romans and the Persians and them other people did, and the Shepherd King did with their crap, but the Kemites didn't believe in that stuff. And this is the Kemite stuff here. So Anuit Septis is telling you, Anuit Coptis is telling you that the Kemite gods, Netters, approve the order of the New Ages, which is a secular nation. Keep Christianity out of America. That was the intent. Okay? Now, let's go to what the one, the arrow and the arrows and the olive branch means. E pluribus unum. Out of many, one. Okay. Now, people, where did the concept of holding the olive branch come from? Most of you are going to say it was a symbol of peace. No, it wasn't a symbol of peace at all. It was the original meaning was not a symbol of peace. They was adapted as that, but it wasn't the original meaning. Let me show you what the original meaning of the olive branch was. And these arrows, okay? Okay. The olive branch is usually a symbol of peace or victory and was historically worn by brides and virgins. Okay? The olive branch, historically worn by brides and virgins. It symbolized peace and victory. Ain't no peace. Victory maybe, but not peace. Okay, here we go. Okay. In Greek mythology, Athene competed with Poseidon for possession of Athens. Poseidon claimed possession by trusting, excuse me, Poseidon, I don't care if you all laugh at how I pronounce it. Poseidon claimed possession by trusting his trident into the Acropolis, where a well of seawater gushed out. Athene took possession by planting the first olive tree beside the well. The court of gods and goddesses ruled that Athene had the better right to the land because she had given it the better gift. So a court of gods and goddesses, many of them, the stars and the universe and all that, the cosmos, ruled that Athene had the better right to the land because she had given it the better gift. Now people, if Poseidon did not trust his trident into the Acropolis, there would not be no water. The seawater wouldn't have gushed out. Therefore, Athene olive branch could not have grown. So now, you know where I'm taking this. If man didn't have sex with a woman, children would not been born. There would not be no offspring. So now people, that's why I told you that Osiris, Asa, is associated with Poseidon. Because Poseidon, let's see what, hold up. Poseidon. Or Poseidon. That's how they say it, Poseidon. His main domain is the ocean. And he is called the god of the sea. Additionally, he is referred to as Earthshaker due to his role in causing earthquake. Okay, now people, what holds the earth in its orbit? What holds the whole earth steady? The sun and the moon, right? But the moon is an anchor. If the moon could cause earthquakes. The moon is an earth shaker. And what controls our oceans, people? What controls the water and earth? What control high tides, people? If our moon, don't our moon control the high tides, people? Our moon control high tide. Our moon control the ocean. Our moon control when the animals are in heat. Our moon control a lot of harvesting. That's why you see they do. That's why you see October with the October full moon harvesting time. So we see that Poseidon is connected to the moon, and he's similar to Osiris. Okay. Now, that's what I'm trying to say to you guys. Virgin, right? Doesn't that mean someone who did not have sex? Let me show you what virgin really means. That's why they call it virgin and olive, okay? Virgin and olive, right? Remember, virgin and olive. Let me show you what virgin really means. Look. Hold up, sorry. Okay. In Greek religion and mythology, Athena or Athene is a goddess of wisdom, courage, inspiration, civilization, law, justice, warfare, mathematics, strength, strategy, the arts, craft, and skills. Okay, people, see what Athena represents, right? Let me read them again. Is a goddess of wisdom. Who represent wisdom, people? Tehuri. Tehuri represent wisdom. Remember, all these religions came from Kemet. Okay, remember, may I remind you all these religions had their origin in Kemet. All these religions had their origin in Kemetic philosophy. Okay? So, where was I? Okay. So, we see here, Athena is a goddess of wisdom, courage, inspiration, civilization, law, justice, just warfare, mathematics. Okay? Now, who does she remind you all of? A few people. First, let's take Maat. Who's Maat? The twin sister of Tehuri. Oh, there we go. Remember I tell you all that? She is the goddess of wisdom, courage, inspiration, and all that stuff. Now, you know all this is intellect and world power. Because you have to have intellect, wisdom, and world power to be civilized, law, justice, just warfare. That means you don't fight for anything. You got to be just. Mathematics, strength, strategy, the art, craft, and skill. All those come from what? Word power, wisdom, and intellect. So now you see, I showed you all how Poseidon is connected to the moon. And I'll show you all how Eru is connected to the moon and the eye. Now I'm showing you all, if I tell you all that Poseidon is Osiris, wouldn't Athena also symbolize Isis? Remember, Eru was born from a virgin birth, from the seed of Osiris. So now I'm going to show you all. So, who's Maat? Maat is the twin sister of Tehuri. Who is Tehuri? Tehuri is connected to the moon. And similar word power, intellect, and wisdom. Almost the same, actually same as Athena. Maat is the twin sister of Tehuri, the Neta goddess of truth, order, law, and justice. Same as Athena. The same as Athena. She would sit at the throne of Asa. Who's Asa? Osiris, Asa the moon. So now we see Tehuri is connected to the moon. Maat is connected to the moon because she's the twin sister of Tehuri. So they're both connected to the moon. And where are they sitting? At the seat. She was set at the throne of Asa. Who's Asa? Osiris, the moon. So now you all see people, you all see the connections here. Okay. While the hearts of the dead were being weighed against the prince, against her ostrich feathers. Now people, but there's a connection between this eagle, this branch here, and Athena. Okay, so leave it there, man. Okay. So now Maat was set at the throne of Asa, the moon, while the hearts of the dead were being weighed against her ostrich feather. Her feather represent divine law, same as Athena. Okay, law and justice. Okay. Symbolizes harmony, divine order, and mathematics. Okay? What a just war is a divine order. Because it's just. So you see, Athena have the characteristics of Maat. But we know, people, Tehuri is really the uncle of Eru. Tehuri is the uncle of Eru. Okay? So which means that Maat is also Isis. Okay? Who's Isis? Aset, the wife and queen of Asa, queen of the Netura gods, mother of Heru. Now remember, people, if Ra is the king of the Netura, Ra supposed to represent the physical sun. Ra is neither man nor woman. He can be both. So, if Aset is the queen of the gods and Ra is the king, what does that tell you all? By default, because Osiris is dead and he cannot rise without the sun, so who's Aset? Because this will be like the same. Interchangeable. They're interchangeable because the sun, the moon doesn't exist without the sun. He have no power of his own without the sun. So they are a binary, a duality. So, Aset, mother of Heru, okay, archetype of the loving wife, devoted mother, and queen of the universe, symbolizes female wisdom, wifehood, motherhood, and nourishment. Okay, remember those things, symbolize female wisdom, wifehood, motherhood, and nurturing. Remember, Athena was the one who planted the tree. So she created life in that land because obviously there was no water. It was bare, it was barren. If Poseidon did not thrust his trident into the Acropolis, the land would have been barren. Because there would not have been no water, no sperms. Athena could not have planted the tree and it grow beside the well of water. It wouldn't have happened. So she symbolized female wisdom because she was smart enough. She was smart also. She outsmarted Poseidon because he trusts his sword. And she trusts life. She gave life. So she gave the better gift. Female wisdom, wifehood, motherhood, and nourishment. That's what she gave to the land. Okay? And remember, Heru, born of an immaculate conception and virgin birth from Aset. So you see, it's two things. He wasn't just born from immaculate conception and a virgin birth. So immaculate conception and virgin birth aren't the same thing. It's a conception, people. An immaculate conception. It was conceived in the mind and came into reality. And virgin birth. But it wasn't a birth where there was no sex. Because I'm going to show you all that they've tricked you all into thinking that virgin birth meant someone who had that God somehow created man, this superman, by just saying, let there be. There was no physical interaction between Mary and her man. No. That's what I want you all to believe. But I'm going to put that to rest right now. Athene. Okay. Bear with me. Remember, I'm just doing this from Wait a minute. Look at this, people. I didn't even say this, people. The Greek philosopher Plato identified her with the Egyptian deity Neith. But that's not even what I want to show you guys, people. Hold up. Wow. That's powerful, people. Let me go up here first. Show y'all what virgin means, okay? Okay, Athena is also a shrewd companion of heroes and is a goddess of heroic endeavor. She is the virgin, patroness of Athens. People, what's a virgin? So I'll show you all now. Remember, I'll show you all the connection between Athena and Isis. Isis is the virgin who Mary emulates. Isis. Mary, mother of man, mother of the first son of God. Okay, the first son is telling you all, Jesus Christ was the first, but it wasn't Jesus Christ, they just stole that. Herod. So, I show you all Athena and Aset, Isis, Mary are one and the same. They are the mother, they are virgins. Now, let me show you all what virgin mean. Virgin. The word virgin comes via Old French, virgin, from the root form of Latin, virgo or virga, genitive. Okay, virgin is meaning literally maiden or virgin, a sexually intact young woman, a sexually inexperienced woman. But we know that's a lie, people. I'm going to show you how it's a lie. Okay, to find out that virgin doesn't mean a girl who had never had sex, we gotta go to the root of the meaning. Now, Latin, we know old French, and all those came from Latin. Okay, because these people all mix and mingle, because the root is from Latin. See, oh, I was right anyway, and I read it and I didn't even realize it. So, Old French came from Latin. Okay? The root. Now, the root of the word was virga. What virga means? Okay. The Latin word likely arose by analogy with a suit of lexemas based on vireo. Vireo meaning to be green, fresh, or flourishing, mostly with botanic references, in particular, virga, meaning strip of wood. Okay, so we know, so we say it means, it comes from the word meaning to be green, fresh, or flourishing. We know that Osiris is supposed to be a green man. He's associated with vegetation. Okay? The oldest net of farming, fertility, harvest, and vegetation symbolize cosmic power, conception, and eternity. So, what I'm trying to say is that virgin doesn't mean you don't have sex. It means that you're ripe. You're pregnant, you're fresh, you're flourishing. You are, how you call it? You are ovulating. Yeah, you are ovulating. Isis, Mary, they was ready. They were ready to have children. So when Poseidon thrust his trident into the earth, water came forth. And Athena planted the seed, the water in her womb, and life came. Life came. So that's how we see the connections. Okay? Okay, people, to interject real quickly, right? I swear to you, before today, before this moment, I never read this before. All the claim I'm making to you about how Athena represent Isis, I swear to you, I never seen that before. I never heard it. I never read it. I never even read upon anything about Athena until today. So, just to interject real quickly, this is, wow, look at this, people. Love and kids and virginity. This is proof, right, that Athena really emulates Isis and Virgin Mary. And also, Nit. Look at this, people. Athena was loved by most everyone and was a very loving person herself, but she loved everyone in the filial sense, like a sister, and was completely uninterested in sex. There were tons of gods who would have given their eyes to marry her, but she was completely disgusted by the idea. Once during the Trojan War, Athena had to ask Hephaestus to make her a set of armor and weapons. She offered to pay him, but Hephaestus insisted that his only payment would be love. She completely missed the sexual innuendo and agreed. When she came to Hephaestus, whatever his name is, smithy, to pick up her stuff, he came at her and tried to ravage her. Obviously, that didn't happen. Don't think too badly of Heph, though. It really wasn't all his fault. Poseidon had played a joke on him and told him that Athena was on her way to the smithy hoping to make valiant love to him. Athena totally ran away from the unfortunate Hugh Hefner, but she didn't move quite fast enough, and he ejaculated on her leg. Athena was completely grossed out and wiped it off with a piece of wool that she then dropped on the earth. That would be Gaia. So people, do you all see, look at this picture here, people. Do you all see the similarities? Okay. She wiped it off with a piece of wool, then she dropped it on the earth. That would be Gaia, and she was fertilized by the semen on the wool. Gaia was revolted at the very idea of it, and so she refused to bring up the child. Athena was fine with this and decided to bring the kid, who she named Erectonius, Earthborn. Earthborn. You see that, people? Okay. Of herself. There's more to this story involving love, suicide, and people getting turned into stones. But people, just so you see, I never even knew anything about this story. Never even heard it. I read it. I just conjured it up in my head that she sounded too much like Isis and Meth and them to me. So that's why I say they were one and the same. And the story was so similar to me. So, and all these people, I found everything, all the information I give it to you, I found it now. Okay? In the now. So, now let me give you all about gear. Net. Remember, people, you all see for yourself that I didn't know anything about that she was connected to the Egyptians when I was reading it to you guys. Origin traditions. The Greek philosopher Plato identified her with the Egyptian deity Nit, which they say would worship at the city of Sais, located at the delta of Egypt, as the founder of the city. She was the god, the war goddess, and huntress deity of the Egyptians since the ancient pre-dynastic period. Sekhmet, who is also Maat. Sekhmet is the hunter of Ra. Okay? Who was Ra's assassin? Sekhmet. Okay, that's who Ra sent out to do his killing when people go astray. You all know the stories. Anyway, the point being the similarities. She was a war goddess and huntress deity of the Egyptians since pre-ancient, pre-dynastic period. The ancient Greeks believed that Athena had visited many mythological places such as Libyas, Triton River in North Africa, and the Phlegrean Plains. Scholar Martin Bernal created the controversial Black Athena theory to explain this associated origin by claiming that the conception of Neith was brought to Greece from Egypt, along with an enormous number of features of civilization and culture in the 3rd and 2nd millennium. There you go. I didn't know this before, but now you all know along with me. So the Greeks did steal their stuff from the Egyptians, from the Kemet. So I was right. Athena is associated with Isis and Met and all of them. Now, bear with me a second. Yes, where are I going to go with this? So now you all see people that these images and US dollar bill, right? They don't mean, they're not no monsters. They're not the devil. They don't mean nothing evil. It means that stay the hell away from religion. Order of the new age. New order of the ages. And with Coptis. He approves our undertaking. Because the Kemets believe that we are all God. We are all an aspect of the divine. The point of all this is, the cosmos is like a book. So, anyone who learns a language can read the knowledge and history of humanity. People have just showed you all this and I've read it. I've read to you all the meaning of this. And it's so simple, people. It is so simple. An eye on top of a pyramid. How the hell could I symbolize the devil when it's just a monument a man built? You see in the center here, you have a picture of the Sphinx with the two pyramids in the background. Well, people, what does the Sphinx look like? It looks like a female. Not the ugly monster that they have there, and they say it looks like Khufu. No, Khufu didn't even build the pyramids out of the Sphinx. The Sphinx is Met. Because remember, the pyramids are the throne of Asa. The pyramid is the throne, the judgment seat of Asa, Osiris. And Met would sit at her throne. Met is also Isis. She's at the throne of her man. Her husband, she's the queen. The queen is sit at the throne. Don't a queen sit at the throne of the king? And remember, there are also monuments to the sun. Because the sun comes up and shines its light on the moon, which is the eye. In the pyramid, the sun shines light on it, and that's how it illuminates. But let me show you guys one thing, that even in your Bible, it said that God is the sun on the moon. First David said, for God is the sun and the shield. A lot of you Christians are going to tell me, oh, it doesn't mean that. But yeah, he said, God is the sun and a shield. Okay? We know the moon is our shield, and we know the sun is the sun. But look at this one, what it says in Joshua, when Joshua went to fight the people at Jericho. There was a battle going on between the Israelites and whoever they was fighting. Whoever they was fighting, right? Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the armor. They were fighting the Amorites. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he said in the sight of Israel. Remember, people, who Joshua was speaking to? He's speaking to the Lord. And who did he address? He addressed the Lord in the sight of the children of Israel. And what did Joshua say, people? He said, sun, stand still over Gibeon, and moon in the valley of Aijalon. Very important, people. Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord gave him victory. And he said, in the sight of Israel, In the sight of the people. This is what Joshua said in the sight of the people. Sun, stand still over Gibeon, and moon in the valley of Aijalon. People, I ask, who is Joshua speaking to? He's speaking to the Lord. And where? In the sight of the people. But which Lord, who did he address? He didn't address some invisible thing. He said, sun, stand still, and moon, don't go down. So the sun stood still. So people, who did Joshua say to stand still? Who did Joshua speak to? He spoke to the Lord, God Almighty. And he said, sun, stand still. And he said, moon, don't go down. And who obeyed him, people? So the sun stood still, and the moon stopped, till the people had revenge upon their enemies. Okay? Is this not written in the book of Joshua? So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven and did not hasten to go down for about a whole day. And there had not been no day like that before it or after it that the Lord heeded the voice of a man. For the Lord fought for Israel. So the sun obeyed him. The sun heeded his voice. Just what I wouldn't say, Jehovah, don't let the sun go down. He said, sun. He didn't say, God, don't let the sun go down. He said, sun and moon. So right there, I'm showing you all, people. And the US dollar bill is a photo of the sun and the moon. Don't lose your intellect over this religious nonsense about dying and going to heaven in Jesus' name. America was meant to be a secular nation. Okay? And people are thinking that Freemasons are devils and how these people are evil. But people, I have another joke for you guys, people. It is so happened, people, that the other day, I seen this video on TV and I videotaped because it was so funny. Look at this, people, with this lady who went berserk in the US Congress and start talking about this right here. Look at this, people, and the Constitution. Well, people, I almost forgot. I got something even more beautiful to show you guys. But before I show it to you guys, let me give you a clip glimpse first. The 4th of July. What does the 4th of July, Independence Day, have in common with Egypt? Huh? I'm going to show you all. Kemet, Egypt. You see them? Kemet, Egypt. Let me give you a quick piece right there. The fact of the matter is that the core foundation of government in the United States of America are based on and derived from the original spiritual belief system of ancient Kemet, Egypt. Specifically, the role of number 7s and 13s and the use of symbols. But now remember in here, people, first let me let you see the video first, then after you see the video, I'll give you the laugh.
The weeks of maneuvering and bickering have meant long hours and lots of stress for people who work on the edges of Congress, those who really do the people's business without fanfare or hidden motives. For one woman, a House stenographer, that stress may have been too much. That's her in the highlighted circle as she marches to the podium. What happens after that is truly sad and bizarre. Constitution would not have been written by Freemasons. They go against God.
Oh, come on.
You cannot serve two masters. You cannot serve two masters. Praise be to God, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lawmakers who witnessed the apparent unraveling of their colleague were shaken and baffled.
I don't know what she was talking about. I was there when I saw it. First of all, I started screaming. I thought it was somebody telling us we had 2 minutes to vote or a minute to vote. I thought it was some official person. And that's how she got there. Like, the sergeant at arms didn't try to stop her.
Because she works there.
And she works there, and that's where she's situated. And she actually went up behind the podium where the president speaks from. They thought she was going to hand something to the speaker. And then they realized, and then she was caught off. But all of this happened in about 10 seconds. And but I was talking to people afterwards to work with. Said she's a perfectly normal, rational person. And but she seemed to just lose it.
Capitol Police tell us they were able to talk to the woman before she was taken to a local hospital for evaluation.
Here we go. Okay, people, remember that lady said, right, that the Constitution could not have been written by the Freemason. Remember her words. Let me debunk her, what she said. Now, I'm going to debunk her and all you American Christians who think that this stuff came from the devil, okay? Dr. Kwame Nantumbo. Kwame Nantumbo is Professor Emeritus at Kent State University, United States. America's 4th July and Ancient Egypt. From Nama to Obama. You saw it in June 2009. As the United States celebrates its independence on 4th July under the leadership of its first African-American president, it is indeed a purpose to delineate the direct correlation, connection, linkage between the spiritual beliefs system of ancient Kemet, Egypt, in the BC era and the founding of the United States of America in the AD era. This Kemetic Egyptian spiritual belief system has come to be known widely under the misnomer of mystery system. Egyptian mysteries are Freemasonry. Put simple, Freemasonry is a system of morality and spiritual advancement. It is a science which is engaged in divine truth and employs symbolism as its method of instruction. It not only seeks to erect the human society based on the principle of truth, injustice, and morality, but also to bring humankind from darkness to light and to form mankind into a great redemptive brotherhood. Okay? At the outset, it must be stated that most of the founding fathers and our president of the United States were Masons. That is, they were all deep learned in the spiritual teaching belief system of ancient Kemet, Egypt. They, President George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe, Andrew Jackson, James Buchanan, Andrew Jack Johnson, William K. McKinley, Theodore Roosevelt, Howard Taft, Warren G. Harding, Franklin D. Roosevelt, Harry Truman, and Gerald Ford. In addition, about one-third of the 56 signatories to the American Declaration of Independence were also Masons, including John Hancock, Lyman Hall, Benjamin Franklin, and Robert Payne. I don't know if this Robert Payne was a brother of Thomas Paine, because Thomas Paine wrote, "The Christian religion is a parody on the worship of the sun, in which they place a man called Christ in the place of the sun and pays him the adoration originally paid the sun." So Thomas Paine, they all didn't believe in the Jesus Christ. But they couldn't come out and say it because of the Christians. They were afraid that it would cause a rebellion, because remember, they used Christianity to keep people in slavery, and they used Christianity to justify slavery. So they tell the slaves, "Oh, we have these people are pagans and we're doing Jesus' work to civilize them and bring them to Jesus." So they're saying slavery was ordained by God and Jesus. So they could not well tell us this stuff, knowing that the people would rebel. So what they did, now they hid it. But they put it on their symbols to show the wise, those who have eyes to see, let them see. So anyway, the fact of the matter is that the core foundation of government in the United States of America are based on and derived from the original spiritual belief system of ancient Kemet, Egypt. Specifically, the role of numbers 7 and 13 and the use of symbols. By way of elucidation, the ancient spiritual significance of number 7 is that it denotes completion, while 13 denotes transformation, resurrection, new life, and rebirth. Now, people, isn't that familiar? 7 is that it denotes completion. while 13 denotes transformation, resurrection, new life, and rebirth. People, the moon. How many phases of the moon going? 13 phases for 13 months. The moon transform from stage to stage until it become a full moon. New life, rebirth, resurrection. Because Seth cut his brother Osiris into 13 pieces. And from the 13 pieces came man. Because when they put him back together, he was resurrected through his son Hero, to mankind. So intellect is resurrected to mankind. The concept of intellect is a thought. It's materialized into us. So the 13 symbolize the 13 phases of the moon. And we know that Osiris is the first one who was killed. Not Jesus Christ. Osiris was killed. Osiris was killed. He's the first one who rose from the dead. Osiris, not Jesus Christ, not even Hero. It was Osiris, was the firstborn from the dead. So, Osiris rose from the dead. Osiris, conception, cosmic power, which called him to resurrect, transformation into Hero, and eternity. Because as long as the cycle keep going around, as long as the moon keep going through its cycles, life will always remain on Earth. It's going to transform. We die. New life comes up. Resurrection, new life, and rebirth. That's what the moon symbolizes. That's why the number 13. Now, the United States achieved its independence on 4th July 1776. The choice of the month of July by the founding fathers of the United States signified that the July 7th month of the year, they complete their revolutionary struggle for independence from colonial Britain. The choice of the 4th of July denotes that on that day, the United States was transformed from a colony of Britain to a sovereign independent nation state. In addition, the 4th July falls within the summer solstice of ancient Kemet, which runs last from 21 June to 4th of July as period of 13 days. A period of 13 days. It is therefore no accident that the founding fathers of the United States specifically chose this day to coincide with their spiritual belief system, blessing, protection, guidance of ancient Kemet. Remember I told you all, he approved our undertaking, something like that. So you see the dates, people, that these people choose. It's all significant. Moreover, the choice of 1776 also denotes that 7 plus 6 equals 13. Okay? I don't know where that comes in, because it's 1776, not 7 plus 6. Anyway, this means that the founding fathers of the United States veiled, shrouded their new state in the swaddling clothes of ancient Kemet, Egypt, Africa. Okay? In addition, the 13th Amendment to the United States freed the slaves. So see y'all people? So you all see. In addition, the 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution freed the slaves. The same slaves whose God they were using. This indicates that the amendment gave the slaves a new life as freed men. Moreover, when the United States achieved its independence, there were only 13 colonies. This denotes that there was a rebirth in this former colony of Britain. Furthermore, the powerful symbol in the armory of the United States, namely the official seal of government, contained 13 layers. The most powerful economic symbol of the United States, namely the $1 bill, bears a picture of an ancient Kemetic Egyptian pyramid with 13 layers. This is also the eye of the ancient Kemetic Egyptian god Hero. as the all-seeing eye for protection on the U.S. $1 bill. That's why I say, in God we trust. All-seeing eye for protection. Because what does the left eye symbolize, people? What does the left eye symbolize? Widget, the left eye of Herod, lost in his fight with Seth. Symbolize healing, protection, and health. So the U.S. $1 bill is granting the United States healing, protection, and health. And these people are going around saying it's the devil. So you all disrespect it. So how can America be healed and have protection and health when you are calling the son of the devil? This ancient Kemetic Egyptian Masonic symbol is now the official trademark symbol of one of America's major television conglomerates, namely the Columbia Broadcasting System, CBS. In terms of symbols, the colors red, white, and blue of the U.S. flag that symbolize the American way of life and global power are derived from the original ancient Kemetic Egyptian red crown of the south, white crown of the north, and blue crown that symbolize the Masonic system of governance, way of life, and being. So you see what the colors mean, people. Okay. They came from Africa. The red crown of the south, the white crown of the north, and the blue crown of war. That symbolizes the Masonic system of governance, way of life, and being. Okay. In 3200 BC, Nama became the first pharaoh to unite Upper and Lower Egypt, Kemet. In 2980, President Barack Obama sought to unite the United States of America. Whatever. He didn't try to do shit, Obama. Stop lying. Okay. The Alpha has finally met the Omega in the countdown to the age of Aquarius, the age of change. Okay. Dr. Kwame Nantumbo is a part-time lecturer at Cipriani College of Labor and Cooperative Studies and University of the West Indies. So you see, people, I've gone on long enough now. I hope you all learn something from this, and my ramblings and tumblings down didn't confuse you guys. I try to make this as simple as possible. Instead of I hope I didn't confuse you guys, because like I said, simplicity complexity is a decadence of society. Simplicity is a path to reality and salvation. So anyway, my people, I'm about to cut out. Remember, complexity is a decadence of society. Simplicity is a path to reality and salvation. Hope I haven't bored you all. If you all like this video, let your voice be heard. And pass it on. Remember, speak truth, do truth. Morals are judged by deeds. It only takes a spark to get a fire going. And sooner those around will warm up in its glowing. So you all be the spark. Okay? Be that spark. One love. Because that's how it is, raw love. Once you experience it, you would pass it on to everyone who wants to pass it on. One love, pass it on. Free your mind, and the rest will follow. Paul Muckle here, and I'm out. A chapter a day. Anger. That's my anger. Passion is the key to life. My anger. I'm angry. That's my anger.
For the protection of the wind gusts past 60 miles per hour, certainly that could cause some power outages and some downed trees, as well as the possibility of hail. We have seen some hail reports earlier this
morning. We're not finished yet.
Some of these storms rolling on in. Look at all the You can see across the board here, the flashing white, those are cloud-to-ground lightning strikes. That's not even counting the cloud-to-cloud lightning strikes out there. So there's a tremendous amount of lightning and heavy rain with this storm. You take a little bit of a closer look, and into the Brockton area, but it does fade back into the Easton area. This is an area that's really redeveloped over the last 15 or 20 minutes.
Yes, I'm not done yet.
See if this maintains its intensity.